We are buying these altcoins right now. Let's get into it. So Chris, in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at all the various different altcoins that we are still accumulating today. These are altcoins that we think have serious potential during 2021 bull run, and therefore we are taking full advantage, Chris, of all of the blood that's in the streets. What is it that we like to say?
Gotta buy that fear.
Gotta buy that fear. So we're going to go through each and every one of these projects and kind of let you know why we're buying each one of them. Each have potentially different use cases and different scenarios around them. And we're going to go through and explain what our thoughts are for each one of these altcoins that we are buying. So if you do find this video useful and informative, hit that like button. We both really do appreciate it. And of course, if you want to learn more about those hidden gems or new cryptocurrencies and maybe even make some money, why not consider subscribing to the channel? By subscribing, you're going to be kept up to date with absolutely everything we do here at Cheeky Crypto. It is free and you'll stay well informed. So why not? Right, with that being said, Chris, let's jump down to the desktop and start talking about the very first project that we are accumulating.
Yeah, let's do it.
So as it should be in no surprise, Chris, the very first project that we are accumulating has to be Harmony One, right?
Yeah, for sure. Love this project. Great team, great tech, great community. What more is there not to love?
Exactly. And we've had some pretty decent opportunities recently. Obviously, a top was found and a very healthy correction has been following. And that's allowed us to accumulate more of the one token. Above that, we also run a good staking pool, don't we, Chris? And that's also helps us to accumulate more as well. And hopefully that's doing the same for you guys. We try to make the returns on that pool as lucrative as possible so you can earn even more one Harmony. So this project we think has huge potential for 2021. We are thinking that this could quite easily be $1, and I think it can easily go much higher than that. It wouldn't be too surprised, Chris, if this thing goes to $2, even $3 during the 2021 bull run. The Harmony project in itself is a fantastic piece of technology. It does use sharding, Chris, believe it or not, and it runs 4 shards currently, and therefore you can run transactions in parallel, and it is fast, cheap, and incredibly scalable. It has lots of bridges to lots of different platforms as well, and they are moving rapidly in this space. Definitely something, if you're not already familiar with it, checking out in more detail. But Chris, is there anything else you'd like to add on Harmony One before we move over to the second project?
No, I think that probably covers it off. We talk about this one often on the show, Nick. So yeah, we'll leave that one there.
Fantastic. Right. So the second project that we are accumulating has to be API3. This one was actually in my top 3 picks for the month of April. And this is a fantastic little project that is incredibly undervalued in my opinion. And so this one, Chris, is all about those oracles. In the same way that that you see Chainlink bringing in real-world data on-chain, this is what API3 is seeking after, right? And they were actually the top validator for Chainlink. They learned a lot whilst doing that. And in such an environment, they were able to learn and apply better practices, if you will, or best practice to their own blockchain solution. So they were able to cut out the middleman. And API3 has serious potential in the future. It may not actually fully achieve its potential in 2021 in terms of, you know, the amount of integrations that it has. However, I think the price is going to see a significant rise during the month of, the month of April, but also the year of 2021 and this bull run. I think we're going to see this thing pop hard. Now, current market cap, Chris, of this particular project is incredibly low, $126 million. It only has 100 million as a maximum supply, of which 14% is in the current circulation supply. So ultimately, really low circulating supply, really low market cap. And that's really just testament to how hard this thing actually is to acquire. It's not on many exchanges. And you wouldn't necessarily want to go and acquire it on things like think of what it's called, Uniswap, for example. Instead, you want to go and find it on a different exchange. I actually found this one on gate.io, and I was able to acquire it there at an affordable rate. So API 3 is a fantastic little project, and I think this is going to do incredibly well in 2021. And therefore, I'm just still accumulating it. It's a tiny market cap in the same way that we see many of these other projects that we're going to talk about in terms of market capitalization. And I think what they're doing is going to radically change the blockchain space. And therefore, I think this is going to be an absolute winner long term. But Chris, what's your thoughts on API 3?
Love the project, for all the reasons you discussed. They've got a fantastic team. I think their marketing is pretty good as well. I think the only thing that sort of holds this project back is the fact that it's not on many exchanges. But, that's something I expect to change over time. And that's where you're going to see probably the biggest gains, when people are going to be able to get into this project easily.
Absolutely. And then obviously, Chris, that brings us over to the third project, which obviously has to be SingularityNET. I love this project, don't you?
Yeah, I love it. It's one of those that, we thought we had more time to acquire, how wrong we were. And now we're just literally cost averaging in every single week.
Yeah, this is a fantastic project. For those who do not know, SingularityNET is all about artificial intelligence, or artificial general intelligence, machine learning, and all of that kind of good stuff. Their aim is to basically decentralize artificial intelligence so it's not centralized within a few large corporations such as Facebook, Amazon, Microsoft, etc. And they kind of have a bit of a monopoly on those really high-tech algorithms. And ultimately, SingularityNet's aim here is to create a decentralized marketplace for artificial general intelligence, which allows everybody who would like to utilize it to utilize it at a cost-efficient manner. They're obviously have had troubles, Chris, with being able to scale efficiently and being able to, actually achieve their objectives on the Ethereum network. And it's for these reasons that you actually see that SingularityNet's moving from Ethereum over to Cardano, in their own words, more superior technology. So when they're actually ported over to Cardano, they're going to start to see some massive growth. At least I believe they will. There's a bit of a phase two roadmap that's being developed, and I think that's going to really help push this project forward in the real world. Above and beyond that, though, this thing has a pretty small market cap. It's a market capitalization of $331 million for only having 867 million tokens out there. Now, there's a maximum supply currently of 1 billion. That's going to actually increase to a maximum supply of 2 billion over the course of 99 years. Those are going to be new tokens minted on the Cardano ecosystem. They'll obviously be representing 1-to-1 ratio with that of the Ethereum token, and you can swap between the two. For me, I'm going to swap all of my Ethereum based tokens for the the Cardano ADA versions, or the variant. I'm going to do that because I want to make sure that I'm not paying ridiculous fees on the Ethereum network. And why not? I like Cardano and I like SingularityNet, so I want to support both of those projects. But this one, I believe, is going to do incredibly well during 2021 bull run. But I also think this is going to do incredibly well long term. So really fantastic little project. Anything else you would like to add on SingularityNet, Chris?
I don't think there really is. I just expect this one to do really, really well. Initially, I thought it was going to be an ultra long sort of term hold. But I think once it's on the Cardano platform, I think it's gonna be integrating with some of the stuff that Cardano are doing. And the fact that Charles speaks so highly of Ben and the team, it just fills me again with more confidence that this project is going to do phenomenally well.
Fantastic. Right. Well, Chris, there's a couple more to go through. So let's talk about this one. This is actually a relatively new project to our portfolio, DSLA Protocol. Do you want to give the guys a bit of a heads up on this one?
Yeah, so really like this project. Again, it's one of those that I think is going to do really, really well. Lots of up and coming integrations with various different projects, which I think sets it apart. I think they're going to be working with the likes of Harmony, One, you know, looking to bridge with those guys. Lots and lots going on, Nick.
Absolutely. And again, this is incredibly low value, a market cap of only $137 million with a circulating supply of 6.4 billion out of the maximum supply, which is 7 billion. So not a lot of money has flowed into this particular project yet, but this thing is going to pop when it starts to, when that money starts flowing. And this is all about insurance, right? And trying to protect stakers and all that kind of good stuff. So this one definitely seems, you know, right up to speed with all of the proof of stake platforms that are out there, and trying to protect all of those smart contracts and those service level agreements, those SLAs and all that kind of good stuff. I think this is going to do incredibly well. And as Chris was saying, lots of integrations in the pipeline. So one to definitely watch out for.
I was just going to say on that, you know, that Harmony is just one of them. You've got Polkadot, you've got Cosmos, you've got Band Protocol, Elrond, Tezos, AVAX, so Avalanche, Oasis. So, you know, there's so much that is, you know, is going to happen for this project. So with this one, it kind of feels like you're getting in early, not as early as we could have, but we're still super early for this project. So I think there's lots of price discovery for this one.
Absolutely. And KuCoin is one of the exchanges you can get it on. We got it on gate.io. Don't recommend Uniswap. Those fees are just absolutely astronomical. But nonetheless, we got a pretty good amount here at Cheeky Crypto of the DSLA protocol. This thing is, at least I think, going to do incredibly well during the year of 2021. So therefore, we had to add it to this list. But next, Chris, is another new project, and that is Splyt. And Splyt is a very interesting project. Again, there isn't a lot of data on coin market cap here. I think the market capitalization was around 120 million when I last checked it. 120, I'm sure it was something like that. Really low trading volume at the moment. That's because it's actually hard to acquire. The maximum supply is 500 million. I cannot remember for the life of me what the circulating supply is, but it is quite low. But ultimately, we do have a $3.49. It's had a bit of a retracement currently, and it has it's a relatively new project. But ultimately, what they're trying to do is create a e-commerce platform that integrates with other e-commerce platforms such as Shopify, WooCommerce, Magento, and so forth. And ultimately, the idea here is to synchronize all of your inventories, so you have one centralized or decentralized, in this case, point of inventory that can be then mapped out to all of your various different e-commerce systems. So one of the biggest bug pains that there are for e-commerce platforms is the way of managing your inventory across all those channels. You may have some inventory on eBay, some on Amazon, some on Shopify, some on WooCommerce, some on Magento. And this particular project looks to actually in a decentralized manner manage your inventory so you don't double sell. This is a crucial thing, and it allows for a streamlined way of actually managing your inventory and running your business. So I can see this thing working incredibly well. There's over 3 million web shops on Shopify, and one of their integrations is with Shopify itself, and that's where they're starting. That's happening in quarter one, or should have happened in quarter one. I need to follow up on that integration. But ultimately, we've even seen the CEO of Shopify now talking about blockchain technologies and things. So I'm thinking that there's something going on in the background here between Shopify, Splyt, that's not yet announced, because you're kind of having the CEO out there kind of drip feeding little bits and pieces about cryptocurrencies and decentralized apps and things like that. Then you obviously have Splyt here working and talking about a Shopify integration, join those dots together. I think Splyt is going to do incredibly well. So I've only put a small amount in here at the moment, but I still think this is a project that is going to absolutely do incredible things during the year of 2021. And their use case, I can totally understand. I think this is one to definitely watch. Chris, anything else you'd like to add on Splyt?
Nothing to really add. I just think a solid team as well, Nick. I just think this one's going to do really well. Yeah, I think all of these projects are going to do really well. Hence, I'm acquiring more of them.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Right. So the last one, Chris, should be a no surprise to anyone, really. That has to be Cardano. And Cardano has done incredible things recently during the year of 2020 and 2021. We've been accumulating, although a little bit later to the party, which is why we are still accumulating now. We wish we kind of got in much earlier. Around March of 2020 would have been a really good time. But nonetheless, we were a bit late to the party. And we do have a pretty good position, but this is something that we need to acquire more of. And therefore, we continue to dollar cost average our way into Cardano. We also run the Cardano pool under the ticker Cheek. That is just around allowing us to accumulate more of the ADA token. And obviously, in doing so, we also allow you to earn more ADA token at the same time. So it's kind of a win-win situation there. And accumulating ADA is going to be something that I think everyone would have wished they had done in a few years from now. Obviously, there's the whole Africa and Ethiopia deal that's been spoken about quite heavily for Cardano. It looks like that was actually signed, although not officially released a statement. The subtle hints via Twitter from Charles Hoskinson do allude to a signature finally actually landing on that deal. If that is the case, we're going to start seeing millions of users on board onto the Cardano ecosystem. And therefore, a $20 valuation for Cardano is something that is truly actually possible. And therefore, for those reasons, I do think that this is definitely something that we should highlight to our viewers as something to potentially accumulate. We are accumulating. We run the pool to help you accumulate as well. Anything else you'd like to add on that one?
No, obviously none of this is financial advice. You know, these are the projects that Nick and myself are both accumulating at the moment. You know, and we're going to continue to do so. And yeah, it's interesting. These projects, you know, we could have got in earlier. You know, some of them we deprioritized against others at the time. And, you know, we do talk about, you know, opportunities. Sometimes, you know, timing is everything, right? And, you know, the timing can be off, which means, you know, you can't sort of make good use of that opportunity there. So, you know, it's one of those. And, you know, that's why we're still accumulating some of these projects.
Absolutely. So hopefully, guys, you have found this video useful and informative. If you have, hit the like button. We both really do appreciate that. And of course, if you want to learn more about those hidden gems and new cryptocurrencies, and do consider subscribing to the channel. By subscribing, you will be kept up to date with absolutely everything we do here at Cheeky Crypto. It is free and you'll stay well informed. So why not? And with that being said, we hope everyone has a fantastic day and we'll catch you all in the next one.
Yeah, take care. We'll be right back.